Welcome to the History Channel. The topic, the Silk Road. During the classical era, the Silk Road facilitated the spread of religions, cultures, and goods, and also promoted the spread and syncretism of complex societies like Persia, China, India, Greece, Rome, Byzantine, and Islamic empires. Now to Anna with an exclusive interview from the Silk Road expert, Candace.
Thanks, Stacey. I'm here with Candace, and she really knows her stuff. Now, tell our viewers what led to the development of the Silk Roads and why it is the most important chapter of traditions and encounters.
Well, first, ancient societies had to have a stable agricultural economy, which facilitated the development of specialized labor. The constructions of roads and bridges was also crucial in order for both close and long-distance interactions of societies to occur.
What role did the Silk Roads play in the development of trade?
Because the Silk Roads linked many societies together, people were able to interact and exchange goods from one society to another.
What kinds of goods were exchanged on the Silk Roads?
Well, back then...
I'm from Persia. Although Persia was an agricultural-based society, trade promoted the spread of goods, ideas, technologies, and religions. People traveled along the long-established trade routes, like the Persian royal roads and sea lanes that passed through the Red Sea, Persian Gulf, and Arabian Sea. Additionally, people traveled through the major ports and trade cities like Babylon. All kinds of goods passed from Anatolia, India, China, Phoenicia, Iran, Mesopotamia, Egypt, Greece, and Nubia, and passed through busy marketplaces in Persia. Migrants from the Greek Empire spread cultural and religious ideas such as Greek thought and philosophy. Overall, the Persian Empire contributed many factors in trade throughout the Silk Roads. I'm from China. China played a huge role in the development of the Silk Roads. The trade network was named because China produced the highest quality silk, and it soon became the principal commodity popular among many societies. Silk was in especially high demand in the Roman Empire. The Han Dynasty maintained Central Asia, and with these trade routes, lands from the Roman Empire to China interacted through trade. Chinese merchants traveled regularly to Central Asia and Persia. For example, Chinese ambassador Gang Ying trekked as far as Mesopotamia in 97 CE. Buddhism also diffused to China from India when it became the most prominent faith of merchants. And from there, it spread to the steppe regions where it gained popularity by the 4th century CE. Oppositely, the Silk Roads did not always benefit China. Epidemic disease took a toll on Chinese society. The population decreased by 33%, and this in turn discouraged trade and resulted in a slow and unstable economy. The Silk Roads affected China both positively and negatively, but overall, China prospered with trade interaction.
I'm from India. A large volume of long-distance trade passed through India. Along the Silk Roads, commerce passed through Central Asia to markets in China. Goods like cotton, aromatics, black pepper, pearls, and gems were exchanged for various goods from merchants from China, Persia, Rome, Greece, and Islamic societies. Additionally, maritime trade flourished through the Indian Ocean Basin. Mariners recognized wind patterns that enabled them to sail easily and safely for trading purposes. Indian merchants traded manufactured goods for spices and local products. All in all, India participated in the realm of the Silk Roads trade networks.
I'm from Greece. Woohoo! Greece participated actively in trading throughout the Mediterranean basin on the Silk Roads. Many Greek colonies relied more on commerce rather than agriculture for prosperity because their islands were not sufficient. Merchant ships that traveled in the Mediterranean basin could carry up to 400 tons of goods to exchange with other merchants. This is more efficient than carts used for overland trade in the rocky terrain, the Greek region. Greece was largely more accessible for trade on the Silk Roads through sea lanes in comparison to roads.
I'm from Rome. Rome's specialized production of agriculture set up trade throughout the Mediterranean. Roman military and naval power kept the sea routes free from pirates so that merchants could feel free to trade with people from different societies. Mare Nostrum, which means our sea, transformed into a well-integrated network of communication. Rome deported many items such as silk, spices, glassware, jewelry, perfumes, bronze goods, wool and linen textiles, pottery, iron tools, olive oil, wine, gold, and silver. Rome began to play a major role in the affairs of the larger Mediterranean basin.
Thanks, guys. Now to Anna, who's here with historian Sabrina. To you, Anna.
Thanks, Stacey. I'm here with Sabrina, asking questions about the Silk Roads. Sabrina, we have been told that the Silk Roads allowed prosperous goods to spread to societies to trade with one another. How else did the Silk Roads affect ancient societies?
Not only did the Silk Roads allow societies to interact with each other, but they also helped in the spreading of religion.
What types of religions were spread along the Silk Roads?
Well, for starts, Buddhism and Hinduism were the first major religions to spread along the Silk Roads. These religions attracted mostly merchants, yet became well established in northern India, Iran, Central Asia, China, and Southeast Asia.
We can conclude that many important religions were spread throughout the Silk Roads.
Yes, that's correct. Another religion that was spread was Manichaeism, founded by a Zoroastrian named Mani. Manichaeism was a syncretic blend of Zoroastrian, Christian, and Buddhist elements. This provided a way for the struggling to favor any one religion.
Seems like the Silk Roads provided societies with many positive contributions.
Yes, they did. Unfortunately, they also caused diseases to spread among societies.
Why exactly was that so significant?
Well, the epidemic diseases that were spread consisted of bubonic plague, smallpox, and measles. They led to a great population decrease, thus resulting in the decline of trade. Not only that, but it also helped bring about the decline of the Western Roman Empire.
Everybody sees this, you. I'm the one that lost the view. Everybody says we're through. I hope you haven't said it too. So where do we go from here?
How devastating. Well, at least the Silk Roads benefited societies as well.
Like the spread of religion and silk.
How did the spread of religion and silk come about?
Merchants not only exchanged goods, but cultural ideas as well. This is what led to the popularization of religions such as Christianity, Hinduism, Buddhism, and Islam. Christianity diffused throughout the vast Roman Empire, and with imperial sponsorship from Emperor Constantine, it became the most prominent religion in the Mediterranean Basin.
Hinduism originated in India and through the prosperous economy of the Gupta dynasty. The Silk Roads made the diffusion of Hinduism possible.
Because of its promise of salvation, Buddhism was one of the most prominent religions that spread along the Silk Roads. In Central Asia, oases on the Silk Roads became cosmopolitan centers with Buddhist monasteries. As a result, Buddhism became the most prominent faith of the Silk Road merchants. Also, Buddhism and Hinduism were both spread by merchants traveling the Indian Ocean through the Silk Road trade network. Last but not least, the Silk Roads helped spread the luxury item silk. China was the first to produce high-quality silk, and this became the most prominent item traded on the Silk Roads. And for these reasons, the Silk Roads are considered to be the most significant item of traditions and encounters.
What did she say? What you say?
What did Silk Roads, and how, and why? Now, tell our viewers, what led to the development of the
Silk Roads?
Alright, that's
for both close and long distance.
Why are you laughing?
Well, first,
girl, come on.
Tell us what you
did. Also, crucial in order for both close and long distance.
Interactions to occur.
Founded by us.
Can you practice reading it, Sabrina? It's not that hard.
Oh my god.
Well, at least the Silk Roads benefited the religion and
silk.
So wait,
like,
how devastating!
Start over.
Okay, I can do it.
Start over.
Okay.
Still